Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Well, first of all, let me introduce myself. I am Mehak Dhawan, your host for the day. And today it gives me an immense pleasure to welcome you all on behalf of Oppo Mobiles. Well, it's so good to see you all this afternoon in best of spirits, and why not? This event will have loads to cheer about. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's so exciting to see you, and today we are at the launch of the next big revolution in the smartphone industry. And on behalf of Oppo team, once again, thank you so much for being amongst us today. Well, Oppo as a brand has been offering us innovative and technologically advanced offerings, and today they aim to go a step ahead. Well, today we will be witnessing launch of a smartphone that will redefine the era with several industry first technologies and innovations by its side. I'm sure we all are excited, right? So without any further delay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give you a sneak peek into a future. A sneak peek what awaits you on the other side. So let's have a look. Wow, wasn't that a fabulous showcase and amalgamation of art and technology? Well, I know all of you are sitting amongst us more excited to know more about the product. So here we go. With this time, it's time to bring on board the person who, along with his team, is responsible for bringing Oppo Find X to India. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming Mr. Rishabh Srivastav, the product manager for Oppo Find X. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mehak. And a very good afternoon to all the ladies and gentlemen. And my name is Rishabh Srivastav, and I am the product manager of this revolutionary product that is getting launched today. As you all know, this is a very special day for us, and we are really glad that all of you could join us today. And now, before I can go ahead, let me tell you more about Oppo. Ever since its launch, Oppo has always strived to provide its customers the best user experience and the technologies. Our Selfie Expert series was largely appreciated by our consumers as well as our media friends. It is this appreciation that always motivates us to get the best technologies and innovations so that we always exceed our customers' expectations. With this in mind, Oppo has now entered more than 30 countries and regions. All across these countries, we have more than 400,000 retail outlets that provide our revolutionary product. Now, based on our research and data, there are currently more than 200 million users of Oppo camera phones. Now, that is a huge number. And you must be wondering how. Well, the answer lies within two words: technology and innovation. These are the two pillars of the foundation on which we build our extraordinary phones. A very good example of this is the Oppo N3. In 2014, it came with the world's first auto-rotating camera technology. So back in 2014, we redefined the smartphone era. And today, we are here to do the same thing in 2018. As you all know, the first striking feature of a smartphone is, of course, its appearance and its design. The design is a key element for Oppo. And of course, the innovation is in our DNA. So we challenge ourselves daily so that we fulfill all our consumers' real needs. With this, we have made huge investments in the last few years. And also, I'm really honored to tell you all that as of 4th June 2018, the total number of patents that have been published and granted worldwide are more than 22,000. And also, Oppo is the first brand to introduce the fast charging technology to our consumers. To serve a particular market, one needs the local intellect and the local understanding. For this, Oppo has made heavy investments in the Indian market in terms of localization. The OPPO India staff consists of more than 25,000 employees. And amongst these, 99% are Indians. Talking about the manufacturing, almost all the OPPO smartphones that are sold in the Indian market are manufactured here. Also, our Noida factory, which has a production capacity of 50 million units per year, will be operational by the year 2019. So OPPO is ready, and OPPO is ready to offer its products to its Indian consumers. And today, we are ready to offer our latest addition to the Find series. The Find series is a perfect representation of OPPO's innovative spirit. But before we dive into the OPPO Find X, let's go back in the history and refresh our memories about this technologically advanced series. In 2012, the Finder was a 6.65 mm thick smartphone. It was the world's slimmest body at that time. Then we launched the Find 5. It came with the world's first 1080 pixel screen in China. And then in 2015, we had the Find 7, which came with the silent pulse light and the VOOC flash charging. So this clearly shows that OPPO believes that a smartphone is not just a communication tool, but a piece of art. And this is what exactly the OPPO Find X represents. So the flagship series is back, and it's here again to redefine the smartphone era. So ladies and gentlemen, let me show you how.
There are countless possibilities in the future. There are many desires inside human beings. Greed causes lost in ourselves. Simplify, eliminate the unnecessary details. Return to the purest, simple. Explore the vibrant beauty in life. Break the settled rules. Find the future.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the OPPO Find X. The natural design leaves no sign of redundant element in its body. The elegance and the uniqueness is an artwork with the beauty of serene vitality. Now, having said this, let's finally deep dive into the OPPO Find X. Now, as we all know, the consumers love the full screen these days. So we wanted to design a powerful, yet a beautiful full-screen design for our consumers. The OPPO Find X comes with a panoramic design. It's the modern elegance inspired by nature. The 6.42-inch panoramic screen with a 93.8% of screen-to-body ratio, along with the narrow border, gives your visual experience a boost, and also it gives you a pleasure to hold. With hidden sensors, no visible camera or holes, this brings out the true beauty of this smartphone. Now, isn't that a visual treat? Well, the OPPO Find X doesn't just talk about the beauty. It is equally sturdy and durable. And this is all thanks to the Corning's fifth generation Gorilla Glass on both the sides. Now, moreover, the consumers love to view and experience content on a bigger screen, and of course, with a fast operating experience. So the OPPO Find X offers the full screen multitasking when the phone is horizontal. So now, you don't have to quit your games or videos just to perform your common operations. Now, what I'm going to show is one of the most finest innovations of the Oppo Find X. It's the Stealth 3D camera. Designed to impress one and all, the camera remains hidden when not in use. Hence, the Stealth 3D camera. It has a sleek and uniform exterior. The front camera panel comes with a 3D structured light module. And this coaxial structure gives a sense of motion technology. And it feels as if the phone is alive. Now, talking more about the beauty, there are no holes in the front panel. So the small opening line that is structured in the front panel is for the sound output. The Oppo Find X also comes with the smallest SIM slot for a dual nano. The double-layered design makes sure that you have enough space for the battery. Now, from design, let's come to the fully hidden imaging system. The Oppo Find X comes with a 3D structured light facial recognition technology. With this, Oppo becomes the first Android manufacturer, and the Oppo Find X becomes the first Android model to come with this technology. Now, you must be wondering, how does this help in unlocking the phone? Well, this 3D technology helps in making Oppo Find X having the facial recognition as the easiest way to unlock the phone. All a consumer has to do is just simply look at the screen to finish the unlocking. And this can be done even during the nighttime. And this is all thanks to the advanced 3D structured lighting technology that makes all of this possible. Well, this technology offers much more protection in comparison to the fingerprint recognition. The failure rate of the fingerprint recognition is 1 in 50,000. Whereas the failure rate of this 3D structured light facial recognition is 1 in 1,000,000. Oppo has also conducted more than 300,000 rigorous durability tests on its 3D cameras. We know that an average consumer will unlock their phone 100 times a day. Even after regular use of camera, an average consumer will unlock their phone at most 150 times a day. Now you can move around freely, capturing your perfect pictures. Now talking about the perfect picture, let's come to Oppo's front camera. It comes with a 25-megapixel AI camera with a high dynamic range and 3D AI beauty technology. The 3D structured lighting, along with the AI technology, makes it give you a naturally beautiful image. The 3D portrait lighting offers various lighting effects on a human face, such as the rim lights. The rim lights will make your skin color brighten, and it will make your contour three-dimensional. And there are many various textures like this that you can get in this camera. But this is not enough. We come with the smart dual rear cameras, which will act like a photography consultant. The 16-megapixel camera will help you to get your desired portrait shots in the daylight conditions. The 20-megapixel HD camera helps you to get your desired portrait shots even during the low-light conditions. So this smart duo ensures that you always get your perfect portrait shots, whether day or night. This amazing piece of technology ensures that you get your best beauty solution amongst millions of beautification schemes. Also, our AI portrait mode offers various lighting effects, which will make it easier and much more convenient for our consumers to get their perfect picture with just their smartphones. We all know that how the camera helps in giving us the high-quality pictures. And along with the assistance of the AI scene recognition, it will intelligently identify the different scenes and objects and optimize the imaging effect. It supports 21 different scenes and objects, and it optimizes the image. For example, during a sunset or a sunlight, it will automatically optimize the color temperature. During a snowscape, it will automatically optimize the exposure logic. And of course, the food. It will make the color look much more appealing and, of course, give you a glorified picture so that your selfies always stand out. Now, the rear camera portrait function is one of the main areas that we have been focusing on. The rear portrait AI mode, we give you the stunning and the artistic pictures. These pictures will always give you a sense of professionalism. Now, this was the fun, but with fun comes security. With the Oppo Find X, the consumers need not worry about the protection because it comes with enhanced protection and security. With the Hide apps, it ensures that you get strong protection for your encrypted applications as well as your app settings. And with the Private Safe, it ensures that it isolates and safeguards your important information by putting it in the Private Safe. Also, we have the green security logo with the message notifications, which come along an optimized security keyboard, which always makes sure that our consumers are aware about the protection of their data. Now, with all these amazing features, you must be wondering, how long does the Oppo Find X last? Well, I guarantee you that it lasts a very long duration thanks to the VOOC flash charging, which in 5 minutes of charging will give you 2 hours of talk time. Now, you can even use your phone while charging to play your games or watch your videos without any fear, because with our custom-made wires and adapters, the safety is our guarantee. The phone will not heat up. So the SuperVOOC flash charging is definitely fast, but also safe. More than 90 million users of Oppo smartphones, we have the VOOC charging technology encrypted. We have the VOOC charging installed in the phones. And now, let's go on to the battery. The Find X comes with a 3730 mAh of battery. The intelligent battery management plus the VOOC charging technology makes sure that you get a highly reliable battery. Now, anyone who is familiar with Oppo will ensure that Oppo has a unique aesthetics of color. We have an insightful knowledge about the younger generation's requirement of everything fresh and unique. Hence, with the Oppo Find X, we come with 2 unique gradient color combinations. We have the glacier blue and, of course, the Bordeaux red. And now, after these, let's move on to the performance. Thanks to the ColorOS 5.1, which is based on the Android 8.1, along with the latest Qualcomm Snapdragon 845, the performance is not an issue. We have been partnering closely with Google from a very long time. Thus, our ColorOS will be supporting the Android P beta program. We also offer an enhanced voice activation, which will make our consumers talk to the assistant anytime and anywhere they want. With this, we have a low power and a smart mic, which adds a DSP module. It will effectively and automatically adjust its performance according to our consumer's acoustic environment. This will also put the Google Assistant at standby at all the times. The waking up successful rate reaches up till 95% during a quiet environment. With the NXP's noise reduction module, the waking up successful rate reaches up till 75% in a noisy environment. And moreover, now you can enjoy and unlock your phone with just your voice. So ladies and gentlemen, intelligence is everywhere in the ColorOS 5.1, which always keeps the Oppo Find X one step ahead. For example, we have the intelligent preloading. Based on the AI algorithm, it intelligently reads the user's habits and preloads and predicts the next 4 apps that a consumer might use and preload them in the back end. Now, this will accelerate the preloading and the app opening by 44%. The current accuracy of the preloading application is 87%. So now, the more you use the phone, the more faster and accurate the preloading gets. And the Oppo Find X also comes with an 8GB RAM and a 256GB internal memory. This ensures that you have a smooth multitasking operation, and of course, you get a massive storage for your multimedia files, pictures, and music. Now, this is an amazing technology. And to talk about this technology more, we have an expert with us. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Sachin from Qualcomm, who is the director of the product marketing. Please give a big round of applause.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm really excited to be here at the launch of Oppo Find X, powered by Snapdragon 845 with AI engine. Qualcomm and Oppo have a long history of collaboration. And I'm particularly want to congratulate Oppo for the success over the last several years in successfully bringing innovative products. And thank you for trying to bring our innovation on the chipset side to the fruition so that consumers ultimately benefit. This 845 is a powerhouse, is a performance house. I think a lot of people have already read about it. Power and performance is a benchmark that is unsurpassed in this category of devices on 845. So I don't want to talk much about it. I think everyone knows 630 Adreno GPU with gigabit LTE speeds, etc. It's all powering a premium smartphone here. But what is most critical on this processor is the AI experience and the immersion experience. These are the two new pillars which have been brought to fruition by Oppo as part of Find X. We have a long history of AI. We've been working on AI for several years. This is our third generation AI. And in the third generation, we are already providing 3x of performance compared to our previous generation. What is important is we are taking AI to the edge rather than doing AI in the cloud. There are a couple of reasons why we do that. Number one reason is the privacy of the data, so that when you are actually taking user data through the cloud, there is always a question mark about what happens to the data. Once you do it on the device itself, those questions are sort of answered automatically. Second thing is when you do it on the edge, you are already getting rid of issues such as lack of connectivity or issues in connectivity, and even issues such as, say, low latency, et cetera, et cetera. So it's a very, very powerful, and some of the innovation that Rishabh talked about, they are actually powered by this AI engine. And I'm really happy that innovation may be in the form of audio experience, camera experience, low power DSP usage. Some of these are coming very well in commercializing this device. So I want to congratulate once again Oppo here in bringing these features to fruition and wish all the best.
Thank you so much, Mr. Sachin. Well, ladies and gentlemen, those were some great speeches. I'm really not a tech person, but when I heard this, I really wanted to get my hands on this phone to explore more, and I might get the chance later. But there's one person, the technology master himself. Well, now I'm going to call upon Nao, who has in-depth knowledge about everything tech and smartphones. Well, he closely follows advancements and developments in the smartphone world. When consumers surely reach out to him for any query or suggestions while picking their phone. So ladies and gentlemen, it isn't really wrong to call him the tech guru. So join me in welcoming none other than our dear Oppo friend amongst us, Mr. Rajeev Makhni. And I'll request Mr. Makhni to share his thoughts on the growing and constantly innovating smartphone world. Over to you, Mr. Makhni.
Thank you. Thank you very much for those very kind words. Always good to hear good things about your own self. So, you know, one of the things that I must start off with straight away is that two people did some great presentations here. But the amount of applause that they got was very less. What happens is when they'll make a video of this OPPO and then they'll send it out worldwide, that clapping may not look very good. So what we'll do is we'll all just clap a little bit louder, all of us, and then they'll edit that portion in for the two of you. And the video will look good. So can we just go with a round of applause for those two? I was just kidding. They'll only use this for me. Okay, for the fact that I've walked on stage, we can't use it for the two of you. Okay, thank you. I'm very happy to be here. But the question is that they've already presented the phone. You already know about the processor and the graphic processor and everything else. So what's my job? My job is really simple. It's exactly what I do on my shows and in my columns also. Every company will talk a lot about their phones and they'll all say it's the next big thing. It's the biggest thing that's ever been done. And my job, I think, really is to take that product and really analyze it and say that, is this really as good as the company is, and give a final verdict. So we'll do all of that and we'll do it together. So innovation in smartphones. I think it's the most abused sentence ever. Every company uses it. Every company will say that ours is path-breaking, ours is out of the box, our product is a blow your socks off, it is the next big thing. Every brand will say it. But the big question is that when this phone got released and a lot of us got a lot of those features that have been spoken about here today, there were a lot of headlines which said, is the OPPO Find X the most innovative smartphone in a very long time? And I think we need to answer that question today. Is it really? Because I think mostly when innovation comes in smartphones today, it's either incremental, some previous technology, or it's copied and you change it a little bit more. So real innovation in a smartphone for a very long time has been few and far between. Let me find out if this is my opinion or maybe even yours. So let me find out. Let me just get to a few people I know and some that I don't. So let's find out. Start with Mr. Dhingra. Deepak, you order your coffee later here. Stand. So tell me the most innovative thing that has happened in the world of smartphones in the last 1 year.
The last 1 year.
It has to be blow your socks off. Not, I know most of us think that the most innovative thing is when a company leaves a 3.5mm headphone jack in the phone. That's the most innovative right now in this year. But something that blew your mind, 1 year.
I think the iPhone 10 was one. The way they implemented face unlock was pretty innovative. We've seen the notch design on phones, but we haven't really seen something that can match what Apple's done with the iPhone 10 in terms of the
face unlock. So you think that's one?
And AI for sure. I mean, what the implementation that we're seeing going mainstream for on smartphones, reaching the end consumer and changing various aspects of how you use a smartphone, right from photography to, let's say, battery usage or, you know, scene recognition and a lot of those things. And, you know, finally, we've seen a lot of use cases, a lot of things that, you know, the Measure app that Google has, for example, which lets you measure stuff, and AI-based games and tons of those stuff. So, yeah, lots of innovations.
Okay, so he's saying that there have been a few innovations that he's really liked. Okay, let me find out from one more person then. Ah, I know this person. Okay, so are you embarrassed because of the jacket? Or you're just hiding away. I love the jacket. Love it. Okay. Yeah, it'll fit me. Okay, so most innovative thing in smartphones. I asked Deepak for one, he gave me seven. So one thing that is not a gimmick, that is not marketing, that is not put on the box for the sake of sales. True innovation that made you, made your heart sing.
Well, I don't really know if it can be called a smartphone, but I think the Jiophone was kind of a big deal, right? Getting in the hands of 25 million Indians. And I think...
But what was the innovation on it that made it happen? What do you think? An innovation.
So the innovation was at the operating system, Kai OS, and what it brought in terms of smartphone features in a smart feature phone package at that ridiculous price point, virtually free, $1,500 refundable. And I think voice assistance, that's really sort of pivoting us in the next era of smartphones where you don't have to touch your device and everything is happening with your speech.
Okay, so we've got some good examples, but if you really look at what Deepak said and what has been spoken about otherwise with Ankit, the point that is coming is that there are innovations, there are different thought processes as to what is a true innovation, but eventually it comes down to that they are few and far between. Face unlock almost a year back, right? Whatever we're talking about comes in very small phases. So when the Oppo Find X started to make headlines and a lot of people called it the most innovative, I think it is time for all of us to take a deep dive into it and find out. So let's do this together. So I believe there are three things, and that's what was also touted by you, that there are three major things on this phone that stand out. But are they game changers? So let's go through them one by one. So looks, material, screen would be one. The stealth camera, the way it slides out, would be number two. And the camera and optics technology itself would be the third. So first of all, I have to say that I don't think anyone would deny it that this is a very good looking phone. So you open the box, you take the phone out, 6.42 inch screen, curved 3D surfaces on the front and back. I think that's interesting, but is it innovative? So let's move on then. A zero bezel phone, or near zero as we call it. But then you realize there actually is no notch at all. So Deepak, was the notch an innovation, or was that an innovation that you didn't like? I mean, do you love or hate notches?
Place the electronics that needed to go up there, right?
So if you take away the notch then, yes, and yet you're able to achieve everything else, then that's something that is, where that's, yes, a great move forward. Okay. So I think that's correct. I think that is a big deal. In a world that is completely divided, let's try this out. How many people love the notch on a phone? Exactly. Okay, there is one person who actually loves the notch on his phone. So, okay, so I don't have to do how many don't like a notch on their phone. So in a world that is constantly not divided, it seems like the verdict is pretty much here that most people don't like a notch on their phone. This closes the debate about the notch. It's the first phone with no notch, no visible cameras, no hole at the front or rear for anything else. And I want you to try and do this after we are done. I'm sure some of you have already experienced it. Most of you will experience it here today. I want you to try and do this. Feel the material, the weight, the hand feel. Like I said, it's a very interesting and very different experience. So let's move on now to the stealth camera. I call it the feel-good stealth mechanical camera, and let me tell you why. So I tried this with many people. I gave them the phone and I said, look, I can't find the camera on it. Can you find it for me? So a lot of people said it must be a pinhole. One person even said that where we put in the SIM card, that small little hole out there, that must be the camera. So this must be the first time that you'll be taking pictures this way, right? So that pinhole is not the camera. And then when I did show them how it works, when you just touch that little button for the camera and it slides out like this, most people had their mouth open at least the first time. So it's an interesting expression that you actually hold a device in your hand and you showcase something to someone and their mouth is actually open. So try it out when you get your review units. Give it to a few people, tell them to find the camera, then showcase how it really works. The way it gently slides out and comes back in, like I said, is a feel good. Now, obviously this feels very high-tech, very futuristic, but the good thing is that it's not futuristic, it's happening right now. It's not a prototype that has been shown at the Mobile World Congress and we've been told it'll be at some point, it'll be incorporated in. And the first time I saw it happen, that feeling that I got was exactly what comes very rarely nowadays, and that is, why didn't I think of that? Did you get that feeling? Okay. With the slide out, the slide camera. Yeah, okay, remarkable. Okay, so innovation that makes sense. The hidden front camera also isn't just about a front camera. It comes a lot more. So when it slides out, like Deepak said, it's a means to an end. A lot of electronics have to be hidden into that notch, and that's why that notch exists. So when you take away that notch, this module that slides out has a lot more: flood illuminator, infrared camera, ranging sensor, and then it has that 15,000 dots that will map your face. And those 15,000 dots give you a 3D image of your face-to-face unlock. I think that's interesting. Then the fact that the camera itself is 25 megapixel, AI, HDR, 3D beauty technology, for those that love that or don't love it, it's still out there. But it's a lot of words that are usually strung together. So let's just take a look at what really I think matters to me in my reviews. All that tech that they're using for face unlocking, they're also using it now to make those pictures you take, the portraits that you take, and the scene selection and everything else come out better. So we tried it out, the scene selection, everything that you're trying to do to get a better picture, because this is now your primary camera in every which way, the 3D structured light, to get a better construct of what you're really shooting. So all of that came out well. We threw quite a few things at it, and I think most of them came out well. So any technology, AI technology, Deepak said, is a big game changer. To intelligently analyze what you're shooting, facial features, any structure that you're actually taking, face, the shape of your nose, the eyes, the chin and cheekbones, to use that 3D beauty effect, I think, is worked out well. I think the good part is that it assists you in the portraits when you're actually taking pictures of people, as well as in the scenes. The scene selection and low light photography also came out well. Now, 296 facial features is what it recognizes, including age, gender, skin tone, and skin texture. But I'll tell you the part that I found interesting. Whenever I've ever seen a phone being launched and they keep talking about that it can recognize this, it knows you as male, female, complexion, and everything else, the amount of AI or whatever the software does is so overly aggressive that you end up with almost ridiculous cartoon figures rather than your actual face. So in this one, I think it's really toned down. So maybe it recognizes you better, or the companies have realized that the overly plastic doll looks that come with 3D beauty should be thrown out. So I found another big difference is that the AI in this actually works well. It's just about right. It's not overly doing it to the point that you look like a porcelain doll. AI scene recognition works well. We tried it out with changing an object from one side to the other, from shooting into sunlight to the other side. And everything we threw at it, it didn't get phased. So I think that's good. Supports 21 scenes, and almost every time it reacted immediately to the change of scene and switched some of the characteristics. So I think those are the three big ones for me. Before I give my final verdict, it's time to play a little bit of a game. We'll play devil's advocate out here. I've been tweeting about this phone for a while, and I've got quite a few questions. In fact, several thousand questions have come in, and I'll try and do three or four of them here right now. So one of the first questions that came up is, very nice looking phone, 3D glass, front and back. Doesn't that make this extremely delicate? So I think this is a very valid question, because the more beautiful you make a phone, the thinner you make it, the more glass that you use, obviously it tends to look very, very delicate. But with Corning fifth generation glass on the front and back and a central frame that uses 7 series aluminium alloy, I think this is pretty heavy duty. And we've tried it out in various places, including right now. And we tried this in our studio also. No, it didn't crack, so it's working. So the second question that comes up is that the phone moves away from traditional on-screen buttons because of the way that the screen has been put together. Does that really work? Does that have a very serious learning curve? So I think once you've created a phone with no interruptions, no bezel, no notches, no holes, then suddenly having on-screen buttons breaking that screen experience is pretty old school. So they've given you 3 buttons at the bottom, which are just gestures. And you take to it very quickly. It's very intuitive, very obvious. Within seconds, you will use nothing else. But of course, you can switch that off and come back to screen buttons if you want. Third question is the 3D structured light facial recognition. After all, it's mainly the only way to unlock your phone. So how will it be used? Most companies claim face lock is secure and works very well. But what about at night? What about in dark areas? So with this speckle light detecting system, which has a flood illuminator, an infrared camera, and that dot projector, this worked in very low light. Once again, you'll get to experience the phone, so I'd recommend you try it out. Take it to a dark corner, get it to recognize your face in a light environment, and then take it and try and open it into a very dark corner. You'll see that it actually works very well, and all that data is on your phone and it's encrypted, so it's not really going anywhere else for analysis. And I think the last question is the big one. I've had more people ask me about this on social media than anything else, and that is, the very cool feature, the stealth camera, sliding in and out is very cool, but it'll happen so many times. You spoke about how many times do we actually use it for face unlock, and you gave a number, right? How many times? For that camera to come in and out, between face unlocking and using the camera, you'll use it, what, 200-300 times a day? About 150 to 200 times, which means that mechanical motorized slide in and out is going to be using battery life for that. But it turned out that the battery life is actually pretty good. It outlasts most of the phones in its category. And then he spoke about the fact that 5 minutes will give you 2 hours, which I think is pretty good. And I still think that that cool factor beats everything else. So that's my analysis now for my verdict. I think in a world where most innovation is just marketing gimmicks, I think in a world where innovation comes, like I said, once in 6 months to 1 year, the fact that this has two or three things that really take the entire idea of usage, and eventually that's what it comes down to. You use your smartphone every day as your own personal usage product. I think it takes a lot of things forward that were problems. A notch, we saw the whole room hated it. They took that away. And they came up with an innovation to make sure that the experience is not taken away, and they made it pretty cool. So I'd say my eventual analysis, if the question is this one of the most innovative smartphones in a long time? Let's just put it this way. Oppo Find X has some serious innovation crammed in, and that's a breath of fresh air in a world where innovations really are only gimmicks. So I would then recommend to Oppo that you've done a great job with this one, so congratulations. But I really hope this is just a means to the end, as Deepak said. And you're going to use all these innovations and take things forward with every single release of a new phone, not just in the premium versions, in every single release of a new phone, you have more blow-your-socks-off innovation that you put into every Oppo phone. I hope not making it a very difficult task for all of you, but I think it'll be great if innovation becomes the hallmark of new releases rather than just something incremental. That's my analysis. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Makni, and wow, that's just an amazing technology which has gone behind the new product. Now, let me once again request Mr. Rishabh Srivastav to please join us back on stage. I'm sure everybody's super duper excited and can't wait to lay their hands on the new phone.
Yes, definitely, you're absolutely right. I learned a great deal working with the team for the Oppo Find X, and it gave all of us a lot of pleasure to work hard on something which we knew would bring a smile on everybody's face.
I can really understand the excitement, and we can't really wait more.
Yes, absolutely. But before that, I would like to call upon on stage somebody very special who will tell us more about Oppo and the Oppo Find X. So can I please have Mr. Will Yang on the stage, the brand director of Oppo India.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up as we welcome him on stage.
Thank you. It will be very short. I'm glad to see everyone can take your time and join this event. Thank you very much to being here with us. So we are very pleased to introduce the first most important flagship seen this year, Oppo Find X, into India to our dear customers. Because Oppo is so dedicated to bring and utilize the latest innovative technology to bring us more and bring you more the most advanced products. So here we're glad to see this product can launch in India. So thank you so much, and hope you enjoy this product just as much as we're building it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Yang. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to proceed and invite Mr. Rishikesh Tithe, Director Mobiles from Flipkart, to say a few words regarding Flipkart association with Oppo.
Hello, everyone. So Flipkart has always strived to bring in innovations through technology, through partnerships, through exclusives onto the platform and to the customers. And with the Oppo Find X, I think it's truly a great choice that the premium flagship segment is going to see, because it is really innovative, it's really stylish. If you see the industry firsts that are there, in terms of the panorama arc screen, in terms of the stealth 3D cameras, in terms of the Qualcomm Snapdragon 845, in terms of the abundant memory, I think it's really, truly a great, great flagship device that's going to come in onto the Flipkart platform. And we are very glad that Oppo has chosen us as their online exclusive partner. So thank you for that. I think Flipkart overall, if you look at it, has been the market leader on phones. We have about 25% of the total offline market, 70% of the online market. And with such exclusive partnerships as with Oppo, we want to grow that to about 40% by 2020. So this is a step in the right direction for us, and we are very glad to have Oppo as an exclusive partner for it, with us. Now, in terms of you know, when can you start buying this phone? I think the pre-orders will start from 25th of July. And we promise that we'll give you the phone at least a day in advance of when it launches widely online, offline. So that's one incentive for you to block the calendar. In addition to that, Oppo will be offering a Rs. 3,000 gift voucher on Flipkart for all pre-orders. So that's another positive reason for you to look forward to. So in general, we are very, very happy and excited of partnering with a truly innovative phone and truly innovative brand such as Oppo. And we wish them a lot of luck. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Teethi. Thank you. Wow. What's that sweet sound? Well, don't tell me it's Lamborghini.
Yes, you're absolutely right. That is the Lamborghini sound. It is the Oppo Find X Automobile Lamborghini Edition.
Wow. Tell us something more about it.
Well, this is a special series that is a result of our partnership with the Automobile Lamborghini. It's actually an exclusive strategic partnership between the leading smartphone brand and, of course, the premier supercar brand. And this has a SuperVOOC flash technology. And of course, it comes with a gradient carbon fiber texture, which is made with a very special technology. And the SuperVOOC technology, in 35 minutes of charging, gives you from zero to full battery. So I really hope that we launch this in India very soon.
Wow, well, that's an amazing, breathtaking introduction to the Oppo Find X Automobile Edition. Well, I really can't wait any longer to see this exceptional piece of beauty and technology. So, Rishabh, you have to show us the Oppo Find X right now.
Yes, it's time. It's finally time, guys. But before that, I would like to call back on stage Mr. Willyang, Mr. Rajiv Makhni, Mr. Rishikesh Teete, and, of course, Mr. Sachin Kalandri.
So let's have the four gentlemen on stage with us.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please look above.
I request everybody to please look above and stay tuned. Let's put our hands together, everybody. All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting right in front of you, the Oppo Find X. Well, I would like to request you all to please pose for the camera.
With the phone, please. Are you guys please pose?
With this beauty in their hands. Everybody, come on, let's give it up. And it's an Oppo event. How can we not take a selfie?
Yes, of course. We need to take a selfie. Right, one with the back wall.
Woohoo! Here we go. Rishabh, we can't miss our audience tonight, today.
Yes.
Let's take a selfie with the audience as well.
Okay, I hope you guys really enjoy this. And yes, I haven't forgotten, it's the price reveal time. Well, you must be assuring that this is a power-packed smartphone because the Oppo Find X comes with a ColorOS 5.1 with a panoramic screen, with the latest Qualcomm Snapdragon 845, the 3D stealth camera, the 8GB RAM and a 256GB ROM makes this an amazing experience. So Will, would you like to tell the price to everybody?
Sure. The price would be 5,999 rupees, which it will be available both online exclusively on Flipkart and also all offline stores pan-India from the 3rd of August. Don't forget the time and the price.
Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you so much. All right, with this, ladies and gentlemen, it's a wrap. And thank you so much for gracing today's event, being with us today, supporting us. We hope you had a wonderful time. Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, you all are welcome to experience Oppo Find X at our experience zone, followed by lunch. So here we go. The experience zone is right here on my right hand side.